In this tech talk, I'm going to cover creating the table of contents in Microsoft Word. The process and concept is the same among any version of word processing software. For demonstration purposes, I'm using Microsoft Word 2010. A table of contents is a list of the parts of a book or document organized in the order in which the parts appear. The contents usually include the titles or descriptions of the first level headers, such as chapter titles in longer works, and often includes second level titles or section titles within the chapters as well, and occasionally even third level titles or subsections, like in this example here. So we have first level, second level, and then sometimes you can have also third level sections, depending on how long the report or the book is. So the question is, how do we go about creating a table of contents? So for the sake of demonstrating this, I'm using just a document that I copied from the internet and put it in Microsoft Word. So this is a long report, 24 pages at this point, and we want to create a table of contents. The concept of table of contents is very simple. It's basically you just have to go through each section of the document and specify what type of heading that section is. So in our case here, this is our title. So we select this and we mark this as heading number one, for example. Then we scroll down. Let's say this section here, this is heading number two. Notice it's under styles here on the very top. And then we scroll further down throughout the document or the report and specify the headers for each section of the report. In this area, for example, let's say we want this as heading number two, and then this we could specify it as heading number three. Note that you can't specify heading number three unless you have specified somewhere heading number two. So basically you can't have two headers or two levels down without having done the previous one. And you go through the document however it's logically organized and specify whatever type of header it falls under. Let's say this is heading number two, heading number three, say heading number four for whatever reason, and go all the way to the top. Let's say heading number one. You're starting a new chapter, a new section or some sort, and then heading number one as well for this section. Okay, so basically you're just going throughout the document, like I said, and marking it as to what level it falls as far as the logical organization of the document. At this point, let's say we are done with marking the whole document. And we go to the very top. We assume that you want the contents or the table of contents on the very top, so we hit enter once. And then we want to insert the table of contents. Click on references, and then you choose table of contents. Once you click on the table of contents, we have different designs, and you simply pick the design that you prefer. So let's say I'll choose the automatic table 2 design. And notice the table of contents has been created automatically. Now, if you go and change somewhere in the document, let's say you change one of the headings and you mark it as a different header, let's say this heading, you either add it or you modify it or you change it some way, you go back to Home tab and you specify a different. Let's say we make this, instead of heading number three, we make this heading number two, so shared information. Now, in order to update that in the table of contents, you need to go back to the table of contents, click once on it, and then choose update table. This function, it will update, choose the update entire table. That will update the definitions for the new styles that you're using, for the new headers that you're using, as well as the page numbers corresponding to. Now, if you want to take this further, since we are discussing the table of contents, and I'll do another tech talk on this specific item. Now, how do you modify? Let's say I want to format this heading number 2 differently. So it's a different font or a different highlighting and that type of thing. What you can do is simply select that section of heading number 2, or simply go to heading number 2, right-click on it, and choose Modify. Once you click on Modify, you can specify a different type of font. You can change, let's say, to italics, make the size smaller, and underline it if you'd prefer, or a different color, and different set the different properties here. You can change also the formatting for the paragraph, the all kinds of other options, and then choose automatically update. Click OK, and now wherever that style or that heading is applied, it has been updated throughout the document. Notice I didn't have to go to this section or this section. If for some reason you changed your mind again, right click on the style, choose modify, and let's say we want to make it to underline it. Just choose underline, click OK. Notice now it'll be updated everywhere throughout the document. So as far as the changing of the theme, right click, choose modify, choose whatever properties you want to modify in that document or in that style, click OK, and it's applied throughout the document. So in this tech talk, you learned how to create a simple table of contents, as well as modify the different styles, the heading styles, for your document that you are working. You can use the modification of the styles, and you can use styles in a variety of ways, not just in the table of contents, but also in day-to-day formatting of documents. That is it.